I'd like to do an example of finding the tangent vector t of t. In fact, one of the key words in here to notice is the word unit tangent vector. I don't think I did this in the notes, so I wanted to go ahead and talk you through this. So let's look at problem number 19. To find capital T of t, we're going to find the derivative vector and divide it by its length, because that will produce the tangent vector, and dividing it by its length down here on bottom is going to convert it to a length 1 vector. Okay, so r prime of t in our case, since we have cosine of t, 3t, and 2 sine of 2t, the derivative of cosine is negative sine of t, the derivative of 3t is 3, and the derivative of 2 sine of 2t is 4 cosine of 2t. So if we take the magnitude of that, remember that is the square root of the components squared and add it up. So negative sine t, you square that, you get sine squared of t, negative cancels out, plus 3 squared, which is 9, plus 4 cosine 2t times itself gives me 16 cosine squared of 2t. Now specifically, I'm looking for the value of the unit tangent vector at t equals 0. So capital T at 0 would be r prime at 0 over the magnitude of r prime at 0. So just plug in what we've got. If I plug in 0 into r prime here, I get negative sine of 0, comma 3, comma 4 cosine of 2 times 0. And if I plug in 0 in for T into the magnitude vector, I get the square root of sine squared of 0 plus 9 plus 16 times cosine squared of 2 times 0. Okay, so let's simplify the top and bottom. Sine of 0, of course, is 0, 3, and then cosine of 2 times 0 is cosine of 0. So 4 times cosine of 0 is 4 times 1, which is 4. And then on bottom, I'm going to do sine squared of 0, which is 0, plus 9, plus 16 times cosine squared of 0, which is going to be just square root of 9 plus 16, which gives me the square root of 25, so I get the vector 0, 3, 4 over 5, or dividing each component by 5, 0, 3 fifths, and 4 fifths. And there you go. That's it.